Hello and welcome to Monmouth in Focus, a program about the services and functions of Monmouth County government. I'm your host, Cynthia Scott. Today we are joined by Monmouth County Prosecutor Chris Gramiccioni. Thanks so much for joining us, Prosecutor.
Happy to be here, Cynthia. Nice to see you again.
We're talking about a very important issue, Narcan, also known as Naloxone, which was instituted by the Monmouth County Prosecutor's Office in 2014. Let's start by talking about the program.
Well, we, as you mentioned, in 2014, in June, we started arming all of our municipal police officers with Naloxone, or kits of Narcan, because in more than 90% of the cases, they're the first responders that end up responding to somebody who's suffering from a drug overdose. And the drug, it works very, very well. It'll, in many cases, it'll revive you immediately from a heroin or opiates overdose. But we've seen our deployment go up from 99 that first year in 2014. Last year, we deployed it or used it 230 times. Mm. And this year, with still a lot of year left, we've used it already 315 times.
Wow. So how is it used? If you get a call that someone's ODing, obviously, on heroin or opiates, correct?
Right. So what will happen is an officer will respond, and if they see the person overdose there, laying there, it's a nasal spray, essentially. Mm-hmm. And you spray it up their nostrils, and in many cases, it'll revive them near instantaneously. Mm-hmm. And sometimes the revival can be violent, so you have to be careful if you're a first responder. Sometimes there's a lot of swing of the arms and legs.
Sure.
But it's not a magic drug. I think there's a sense in the population out there now that it's out across the state of New Jersey that this is just some kind of an immunity for using heroin and opiates, and it's the furthest thing from.
That was my next question. For people who are users, do they think that this is, I don't want to call it a free pass, but in a sense, you know, all I have to do is take this Narcan and have an officer give it to me and I'll be okay.
Yeah. And I can never get in anyone's heads individually when they decide to use heroin mm-hmm. and end up overdosing. But in terms of the deployments that we see, them increasing, and we see the number of people who are getting sprayed on multiple times,
right.
and the ages are getting younger, and the number of people who are administered Naloxone but still nonetheless die, we're seeing those numbers go up. I can only conclude, as the Monmouth County Prosecutor, in law enforcement, we're thinking that that's what people think. And we also know from intelligence sources that it's out there and people think that this is something that will just magically protect them. Mm-hmm. And that's the last thing I want people to be thinking.
Absolutely. And Prosecutor, obviously you started this program in 2014 because of the heroin epidemic that, mm-hmm. that plagues Monmouth County as well as the entire state.
Right.
You know, obviously this doesn't address the issue, but it also decreases, I would imagine, the users in a sense, correct?
It does.
Education.
There's no one solution. We try to think of it as a combination of a number of different initiatives and ideas. One of them is informing the public that this is a dangerous drug and it's happening across all aspects of society. It's not confined to inner cities. It doesn't follow you based on your age or race or ethnicity or level of affluence. I mean, it's pervasive, unfortunately, across all of Monmouth County, which is one of the epicenters.
And it's real difficult to prosecutor to learn that a lot of these problems, you know, that result in heroin or start in the medicine cabinet.
They do. Yeah. In most situations, people who end up using illegal street heroin, it starts with innocence. I mean, mm-hmm. it starts with somebody getting treated for an ailment, an injury after a surgery or otherwise. They're prescribed an opiates like an oxycodone. And when those run out, or if they're used improperly, they're cost prohibitive. The pills are out there on the black market, but they're so expensive. It forces people out into the street where they can buy cheap and readily available street heroin that's just as pure and just as effective, unfortunately, as the OxyContin.
And also important, Prosecutor, you mentioned the number of teens that when it comes to heroin addiction, that also could start in the medicine cabinet, but them going in there and looking at what their parents take or looking at what their grandparents take, correct?
It is. Think of it like this. It's a lot easier to go up and raid a parent's medicine cabinet than it is to go buy alcohol or get a prescription from a doctor,
mm-hmm.
right? So that's the quickest and easiest way to get a fix or get a high.
Sure.
And it's dangerous. I mean, that's why we encourage people to dispose of unwanted or unused prescription medicines. You know, there's different sites where you can surrender them. So it just doesn't present a temptation or a risk to anybody in your house.
Absolutely, very important. I mean, we're talking about a major epidemic here. It destroys lives. It's not just a high that you get and then you wake up the next day and you're okay. This is very, very bad stuff.
It's terrible. It's killing people in droves. And people ask me, what kills people in this county more than anything? I think many think it could be violent crimes like homicide. It could be vehicular accidents or otherwise. Those numbers pale in comparison. We're seeing just last year, we saw 101 heroin or opiates related deaths. And we're going to exceed that number, sadly, this year by possibly double.
Mm-hmm. And Prosecutor, how else do you get the word out when it comes to how serious this epidemic is?
Like with anything, we rely on our partnerships. Partnerships that start with our municipal police departments, the sheriff's office, our federal law enforcement partners, organizations like Partnership for a Drug-Free America. And we've been really trying to make inroads and be more active with social media through Facebook and Twitter, since our office has a webpage on both. Mm-hmm. I look at across the spectrum. We look at 115 heroin or opiates related deaths last year. Mm-hmm. And then this year, we already have 101, and that's just through July. And we're gonna blow through that number, unfortunately. So it seems to be a perfect storm of events, with an even scarier point being that it's mostly young people between the ages of 18 and 30 that are dying.
Such a scary point indeed, Prosecutor. Thank you so much for joining us on a very important topic there. Best of luck in this effort as well. Great job to you and your staff.
Thank you, Cynthia.
That is all the time we have for this segment of Monmouth in Focus. More information, of course, you can go to www.visitmonmouth.com. I'm Cynthia Scott. Have a great day, everyone.